McLean, and gone! Smith's got in the way with this one. Wonderful for those in blue. It has silenced this packed house here at Trinity.
It's the angle yet again. Aiming for straight, Colin Munro couldn't quite get the par. Has to go for five. Not his day today. It's 28 for two.
Just that bottom hand closing the face ever so slightly, taking the power out of it. Well positioned, Dwayne Smith. We've got another left-hander coming out, Darren Bravo, brother of, certainly got a useful strike rate. He'd like to get that up a bit too. 28 for two, and he's here because Munro's just closed the face at the last split second.
Yeah, rather like Dwayne Smith was dismissed by Corey Pierre, expecting perhaps the ball to turn a little bit onto the face of the bat, but it just slid on. Hit the inside half of the bat, dragged it to long off. Huge wicket, absolutely huge, huge wicket for the Barbados Tridents. The form that Munro has been in, knocked over both Kiwis. Here is that card, left-handed Narayan, left-handed Munro.
Yeah, I was going to just ask you, gents, about that, and Darren Ganga. I just wonder whether perhaps TK could have split that up a little bit, mixed it.
Agreed. Dennis Ramden had a fine innings in the last match. Might have been really good to get him in. See if Darren Bravo.
Pollard has got himself under the helmet and he's done it right in the face of Darren Bravo. Wonderful byplay. When he was setting the field, he was standing all over Darren Bravo. Oh, yeah. Yeah, a lot of mind games going on. And there's Pollard right behind him in his ear. Yeah, look at it. Yeah. Cover up the mouth and have a crack. This is great stuff. Oh, Mr. Competitive. KP. Right in his face, right in his ear. Now he's gone on the other side. Sell him it off. One hand off the bat, if you please, Darren Bravo. Gets away with it and gets two.
This is good cricket. Darren Pollard, usually very aggressive. And try to take players out of their comfort zone. That's exactly what he's trying to do with Darren Bravo. Distract him a bit. Hasn't been at his fluent best. Last inning, 17 off 21 deliveries. Getting starts, but not carrying on.
He's come out of there, the big fella. Aaron Pollard. There's only one to go. I thought he might have been able to stay. You're staying right to the end. Don't leave your seat. One to go. Mullick. Yeah, super over. Just three and a wicket. 30 for two.
Between these two teams, Knight Riders put five, the Tridents three. The Tridents, however, have never won at Queen's Park Oval. They have an opportunity tonight, though. Springer. Starts well.
It'll be a big test for him. He hasn't played much cricket at this level. Young man from Barbados. Did well at the under 19 level. Both here in the West Indies during the last under 19 World Cup.
Yeah, wonderful opportunity for him on the big stage, isn't it? Well, one thing, playing an under 19 World Cup, it wouldn't be in a crowd like this. You wouldn't be playing with big senior players like Pollard's up against players like Bravo, Williamson.
Yeah, and he would have seen two of his teammates elevate themselves onto the West Indies senior team. Zari Joseph, Shimran Hetmyer, who are currently in England touring with West Indies senior team.
In the power play, so just the two players allowed outside that inner circle, and we're just seeing a slight shift in the field here. Darren Bravo, we're going to go with a long on, which means that we'll have a mid-off inside the inner circle. Stump to stump approach here from Springer.
Can't see a red here on the far over. Fans we've seen here over the last 5 days. All kinds of costumes. All kinds of boundaries. And all kinds of ways to make them.
Lurid shot. As easy as you like. This one is really a freebie. Spring down the leg side. No problems there for Darren Bravo.
T20 match up against Chris Gayle playing his 300th. Extraordinary. This looks like Anderson Phillip for me.
Leave him out so he can't open the bowling anyway.
Yeah, I also think that Chris Gayle has a potent spin attack. And that is what the Knight Riders would be mindful of. This pitch will also favour the seam bowlers. We've seen consistency in bounce over the last four matches. I'm sure in this particular match, the bounce, the pace will be consistent in both teams bowl.
We're starting an hour earlier too, Aaron Ganga. Just wonder about that with that dew factor. It's quite dry today, even though it's obviously humid and sticky with the wet season. But appreciably drier the outfield. Oh, hello, little leading edge. Nerves from both sides, bowler and batter. Gentleman under the pump out in the centre tonight, Langton Rosier. He's from Zimbabwe. And Nigel Duguid. Diana means Gregory Brathwaite will be upstairs now. Third match official, TV ump up there. Denovan hails the match referee. And it sounded good. But there is protection. So, first one off the bat. To go with the wide. Let's just see if this crowd gets a little bit more animated. With the opposition captain now on strike.
Shamar Brooks gets off the mark. He is from Barbados. He's an average of about 17. Known for his all-round ability. This guy is also from Barbados. Gregory Brathwaite. Giving support to the on-field umpires.
Match for Gayle. Oh, hello. And he took his eye off this one. There's the strategy. Cranking up 143, the speed gun saying.
Good bumper this. Full commitment. Just jagged across Chris Gayle as well. Ball barely reaching Dinesh Roundin on this occasion, but the intent was unmistakable from Philip. Cranking it up.
Oh dear. It's going to run away all the way. So useful wides for St. Kitts, not so for the youngster, Anderson Phillip.
Just lost his action here. Over exuberant. Not a good delivery.
Gale happy. No, given leg buys. Oh, Langton. That's not part of the script, son. This is Gale on strike.
Easy thing to do when you get a bit overexcited as a bowler. Trying to run in and bang it into the middle. Lose your action like that.
Yeah, you try and muscle it, don't you? And he fell away badly. And he is searching for pace, so you can't blame him. It would have been the instruction. Get out there. Full throttle. And that'll be another one. Much to the shock of the bowler. He looked round quickly, but sorry, son. Arms are up.
You just see as he's striving away. Bust the gut. Get it down there as fast as he can. The head falls away towards gully. Cover point. Lose all control. You also lose pace.
The nerves jangling. Adrenaline pumping. A bit simple as the kiss theory. It's better. And the radar there. End of the first one. It's 9 without loss.
A good crowd in for a Monday. Jimbegonians always love their cricket. They've shown good support over the past 5 days for this Trinbago Knight Riders team.
School holidays, of course. There's a heap of youngsters in, and that is great to see. Family occasion. Aero CPL is in town. Ronsford beaten. It's been aggressive. He's got people out. And he's a go-to guy for DJ Bravo.
He picked up 2 for 24 on Saturday night against the Tridents. Oh, beautifully. Got that Yorker in. Can generate some real pace.
Oh, and that's the one you got to watch for, Christopher Henry Gale. He's lost his off pole a lot in the past with those.
It's the length. I was just going to say that the line of attack and the length to Chris Gale will be full. Usually when he starts, he's a little bit sluggish with his feet. This is his 300th T20 match. Wow. Experience.
Just a little bit. He's had bowlers from all over the world trying to knock him off his pedestal, knock him off his perch. Look at those runs. That's ridiculous amount of runs in T20 cricket. But right now, these young bucks from TKR are after his scalp.
Yeah, you can see the strategy. That Yorker, and he doesn't get off the crease. The feet don't move quite so well these days. Rightio, the E-Zone, part of the Hero CPL's logistics partners. They're transporting the biggest party in sport around the Caribbean, from Florida to Barbados and St. Lucia to Jamaica. They're ready everywhere. E-Zone and two TV crews zigzag around these gorgeous islands, then merge, ending up right back here in Trinidad and Tobago for the finals. Another one. Yeah, good bowling. And a wry smile from the bowler.
This is what has been so impressive about Ronsford Beaton. as he doesn't lose anything in terms of pace or accuracy when he goes for that full delivery. Quite often, young quick bowlers, when they look to pitch the ball up, sort of float the ball up there and it gets drilled back past them. It's not only when he bangs it into the middle of the pitch that he's got a bit of gas. Once he gets it up there, he deceives people with how quickly the ball fizzes down.
He played his first CPL for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. And over the years, he's developed more control, greater consistency. Another Lenka Liado too. Young, exciting talent. As I've said previously, a lot of the West Indian spectators are expecting him to be on the senior West Indies team very soon, given what they've seen from the young fast bowler out of Guyana.
You're just all you stats gurus, be aware that this is the first time that TKR are using two quick men. All the other games they've started with spin and pace. So this is the first time out, the Trimbago Knight Riders with two paces. And again, looking for a get back, Christopher, and does so. Just, oh yeah, the pressure valve of five dot balls.
And I think Colin Munro was the fielder who picked the ball up at fine leg inside the circle. And I wonder if he hadn't have lost his footing, see the throw coming in, he hadn't lost his footing, that throw would have come in hotter and he might have put Christopher Henry Gale under a bit more pressure.
Yeah, Christopher Gale, very different in approach at the start of his innings. He's already scored one half century, not in his typical aggressive fashion. Scored 66 or 55 against the Guyana Amazon Warriors.
Oh, wants to get off the mark, ruins the maiden, just. He's going to keep the strike, two done, 10 for none. Doesn't hurt a shout for, eh? Or just sit on the fence like you usually do. I'm coming to see you tomorrow, so look out. Been missing you, Big Bish, at your hometown here. Here's Sin on a run. Listen to this crowd.
Stunning record. A couple of big guns going against each other here.
And this is perfect for TKR to have Gale suddenly on strike against Sunil Narine, and he's rather edgy. He wants to perform, of course, and it's taken him an age to get off the mark. Social media here in the Hero CPL, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, you name it, it's all here. Oh, beautifully bowled, Sunil Narine.
Well, at the moment, pace and off-spin are keeping Chris Gale in check.
So the social media, the Hero CPL, CPL are all over the place and they love it. And all those sites, that latest news, cpl t20.com, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all the handles there, the hashtags. Carve up this great tournament. A few more knights in the house. Young Brooks gives the strike back to his captain.
You just get a feeling that something's about to give here. You're either going to see all disappearing 10 rows back or one going straight up the chimney. pressure is building.
And there you go, Mark Butcher. Here we go. And, oh, great effort to get a hand on it. Young Phillip Anderson, that is. Great effort.
You called it, Mark. Just trying to ease the pressure, Chris Gayle. Not getting on top of this sweep shot. Have a look at this. Outside Yossom and hitting under the ball.
Gotsky! Brilliant! Absolutely brilliant. And there's another dismissal for Gayle for off-spin.
51.
51 times Chris Gayle has been dismissed by off-spin in T20 cricket. Dwayne Bravo would know it. Sunil Narine would know it. Bravo positioned himself at slip and Narine delivered with an absolute peach. Gayle's gone for four. 14 for one.
Yeah, didn't quite pick it. Just trying to play it defensively. Through the onside. Took the onside edge. And well, Dwayne Bravo very rarely misses them. Coaches it very easy for the big wicket of the big man. Chris Gayle gone.
Mohammad Hafeez, the professor from Pakistan. He's been to a few CPLs now as this gifted right-hander. Might not have the greatest average, but he is there to work it around. He controls things at the top of the order, particularly if Gayle or whoever else at the opening position gets out early. Now, this has been a wonderful piece of bowling and captaincy from TKR up against Christopher Henry Gayle.
Let's have a look where this pitch is. Pitch is outside leg stump. Oh, it's an absolute japper. It really is. Not sure that Chris Gayle did anything wrong. He did everything right. Skipper Bravo. He's enjoyed knocking over some of his teammates. Big celebration when he got rid of Karan Pollard last night as well. He's having a lot of fun, as is everybody else in the Hero CPL.
Yeah, I wonder who writes his script. Leg side. And a few of these already from the home side.
Young Shamar Brooks must see this as an opportunity to enhance his reputation. Playing in place of Evan Lewis. Typically, Lewis very aggressive at the top of the innings. His recorded the highest individual score in Hero CPL, 92 in the last match. Not in today. One change to the St. Kitts Nevis Patriots team.
Oh, might have squeezed this. A bit of wood, but he's got a bit of pressure on him, young Brooks. Lost his captain. Now he's got another senior pro to join him. The outside edge, beaten, and the top edge. This was a great effort. Anderson Phillip, and there's the other outside edge. And he didn't even look back. Chris Gayle didn't even look back. As soon as he edged, he thought, yep, yeah, it's going to go straight to my mate.
Ball pitched a good couple of inches outside leg stump. It was an absolute ripper. Nightmare for left-handers as the pressure continues to build on Brooks. Brooks tends to, looks as though he likes to get himself back and across onto off stump. And Beaton is just getting wide of the crease and spearing it into him and giving him no room whatsoever.
Power play, so crucial. Half of it's gone. 15 for one. Patriots someone has to spark up very shortly. Is this the first boundary? Oh, you better believe it. It's a hero maximum from Shamar Brooks.
And how easily did he do it? It's like a slow, lazy swing of a driver. Just high hands, just picked it up off the top of off stump. Deposited it over wide mid-wicket. It's an absolutely belting shot.
Some great outfits here. A dead pull happening here. Movie buff Mark Butcher's all over it. God, no! Oh, it was there. Would have been a bonus. But it was on.
Anderson Phillips. Second dropped opportunity for the Trinbago Knight Riders. Young stay in the side for today's match. Had the chance to bowl the first over. In and out.
Not sure he's got a hand on that at all. Hit him in the midriff or in the crook of his elbow.
Yeah, not easy catching it there, Butch. The ricochet into the tummy. Good luck with that. We've had seven off thanks to that maximum of wide to start the over. There's seven off this one. It's a lovely shape. The seam tends to angle towards the leg stump of a right-hander from Beaton. It tends to tail it back into to righties, goes across the lefties.
Yeah, 42 drops so far in Hero CPL. What's going on with the fielding and catching?
True. Stats gurus, Aaron, what's going on? 42. Oh, heck. Well, fielding coaches be busy this season.
Some Kitts and Nevis Patriots have got a good one. Trevor Penny, who was one of the best fielders around, he was putting the away team through their paces before the start. The home team, they got butterfingers tonight.
There's a wide, there's a great shot of Trevor Penny in the Patriots dugout with a little wry smile. He knows what's going on. Hello, TP. Keep working.
Yeah, just to confirm that point, just before the start of today's match, whilst St. Kitts Nevis Patriots were warming up and doing a lot of catches, Trinbago Knight Riders, they were playing football.
How are you going with that, DG? I'm with you. The catching happening with the little white thing. A single to make it 23 for one after four.
Plenty of candidates for the Hero Fan of the Day. Haven't seen that gentleman before. He's gone. He's got religion tonight. He had a knife through his head on Friday. The colour, the glamour, the Hero CPL here. Evening, Melanie Jones.
Evening, Rob Butcher. Danny Morrison. I think Darren Ganger just got out of the commentary box after having a go at the warm-ups of Trinbago Knight Riders. He can't diss the home team, his home team, can he? Let Simon Kadich have deal with him later on.
He's just making a note of it. Just written it down. Darren Ganger. Sledging warm-ups.
and Melanie Jones not coming out on the next boat trip for the finals.
Oh, it's hit that well, and that is going to hurt for a little bit.
Mate, that's football for you. Yvonne Searles, I don't think it's got a hand on this one either. It was struck ferociously hard, and it's just crunched straight into his kneecap and ricocheted about 20 yards away from him. You can see the funny side. That's going to be sore in the morning, pal.
Well, if he doesn't laugh, I think he's going to be in tears, because that hit him flush. No fatty pads to protect any kind of bone around there. He's still down at the moment. It'll take a while to get up from, I think.
Mohamed Hafeez is smarting, saying, God, wish they'd have gone underneath and be off the mark with a boundary.
Well, it could have ricocheted to the opposite boundary. It came off him so hard. Big crowd in this evening. Last home match for the Red Army here at Queen's Park Oval. A reminder that the final matches will be at the Brian Lara Stadium in Trinidad, but moving down south. And they were more than happy, in a way, I think, to see the end of Chris Gayle. Wonderful delivery, an absolute peach from Narine. Dropped the ball before by Phillip. DJ Bravo doesn't drop these, though. Look at that. Chris Gayle knew it as well. Won't even look behind.
Well, Yvonne Searles is still prone on the deck. Teammates showing, well, not much concern, really, as is usual. It's interesting, Darren Ganga talking about playing football. Not sure about Searles' first touch, to be honest. Second touch was a tackle or a throw-in, the way that bounced off him.
So no contract, Butch?
Well, I mean, you know, if you're going to play it every day, you want to... Your control wants to be a little bit closer than that, surely.
The Guardian Group volunteers, they are peppered right around this stadium at the moment. They're in the orange. If you see them at any of the games, go up and say thanks, because the work that they do means that we can see these games, relax, sit back and enjoy.
That guy's a guardian of the galaxy, isn't he? I don't know. But no, fantastic. Done wonderful work here in these last five games since last Monday, making sure that everyone is having a wonderful time.
Well, while we're on a variety of different sports, I think we need to give a shout out too to the Trinidad and Tobago 4x400 metre relay team, who took out gold at the world titles the other day, defeated the US. They were going for their seventh straight title. They were behind in the last stretch, and then on the last little bit, it was Gordon who took over and got the gold for them. So a huge shout out to the boys. Magnificent effort.
And your origin, Melanie? Like these beautiful souls? Ah, Trini. Funny there, Melanie?
Well, Australia didn't make the 4x400 final, so I did get off the bandwagon, didn't I? A couple of gladiators in the ground this evening. He's up. I'd still be on the ground, I know that. Maybe even a stretcher. Colin Munro in the field, directing a few things, taking a real big leadership role this year with the Knight Riders.
Not been a long break in play, and this is why. Absolutely crunched. Off bat and then off kneecap. He's all right. Yvonne Searles been strapped up by Asher. TKR's physio, and we're about to get back underway.
With width again, and punished on this occasion. That is through the field, and we pull up the first four boundary.
I notice Yvonne Searles didn't run after that one. He just left it for his buddy. There he is, on the left. You go fetch it, brother. You're younger than me.
Bad way to get off the mark. Real gladiator theme this evening.
They're supposed to be knights. Gladiators.
Someone's told them a furphy at the costume shop, I think. Nicely driven, but won't get through the field. Thank you. dress-ups have been fantastic here throughout the four games being played so far. The fifth. A little bit of width, but I think we'll be... No, it won't be. Well, there you go. I thought that just snuck back in as it passed the blade.
Now, not happy with the umpire's decision, but just watch the way that this ball reacts off the surface. It's an off-cutter. It gripped a tiny bit, but also kicked and bounced. I think we're going to see a lot more of that from the likes of Kevon Cooper. Changes the pace from the quick bowlers. That certainly did not react the way that Hafeez expected off the surface. Kevon Cooper, second highest wicket taker in the CPL this year, behind teammate Shadab Khan.
Well, a little bit of a half shout to finish off the over. Five overs are gone. No, sorry, my apologies. I forgot about the wide. I just didn't think it was a wide.
Well, this is the beauty. This is what he's looking for. Young Phillip. It's a better line. There's that bounce as well. Nearly, but not quite.
It's really good to see a couple of young West Indian quick bowlers opening the bowling here in the CPL. There was a time when they were all over the world, West Indian quicks. Hopefully those days are returning.
Second slip in now. The gap's opened up and the single is taken. Five overs gone, 30 for one.
Tremendous atmosphere here. Horns are getting a workout. Trumpets. And the flags. Ten Bears is back.
Drums are beating loudly here at Queen's Park Oval. Last game here for the Trinbago Knight Riders. They want to send their fans off with a win. Yeah, one of the wonderful things is just how all the fans get right into the mix of wearing the red. It is an absolute sea of red. You can see it around the world. Often see it at Royal Challengers Bangalore. Kevon Cooper now coming on, second highest wicket taker in the Hero CPL. He'll be bowling to Mohammad Hafeez, one of the 10 Pakistani players who unfortunately will be heading home and not finishing off the Hero CPL. National duties. Width again. And just down. It would have been a magnificent catch.
Well, he's been an absolute live wire in the field for TKR when he's not had the ball in his hand. And perhaps just didn't want Kevon Cooper to be equal with him and 9 wickets at the top of the board. That would have been spectacular. Fabulous little juggle. And at this moment he thought, yeah, I've got it. It's just going to plop into my... Oh, no. Number 43.
Maybe that's why they're doing all the football practice. He could have got the boot to it. Mark Taylor-like. Whipped off the pads very nicely. It's flown out to the protection. Can't keep him out of the game, can you? Ball in hand, bat in hand, now in the field.
Yeah, Shane,
caught up with them before the coin toss, and they've got to go back on the weekend. I think they can play it all Friday, Saturday, and then they head off. PCB have called them back. Yeah, whatever, an absolute snorter. Yeah, just pinched it a little bit too hard with the right hand, and it went too far away from the left. Having a ball though, young Shutter.
Slow delivery. Hafiz is probably telling himself there, just watch the hand, just to see if he's rolling the fingers down the side of it. Packed offside field, five in the inner circle. On the charge, gets a hand on it, and it would have been out. The ball had ricocheted onto the stumps. Had a few opportunities like that over the last couple of days here.
Yeah, just the slightest touches on the fingertips. Been backing up, had the bat in the right hand, but just didn't anticipate what might happen next and got away with it.
Yeah, easy single taken to the onside. It's a pretty open onside. Leading wicket takers in this Hero CPL, Kevin Cooper. He's at number two at the moment, right behind his teammate in Shadab Khan. He's probably thinking, oh, it could have been equal top. Very good over for Cooper's first. The power play's done, 34 for one after six.
Excellent power play to TKR. Seeing teams trying to get off to a flyer, but the ball is hard and new. Happy birthday, Charmaine. But that hasn't been the case for the Patriots. They've been very watchful. TKR bowled beautifully.
Early wicket of Chris Gayle. Sent this crowd going absolutely ballistic. Wonderful delivery by Narayan. Simple catch at first slip by Dwayne Bravo. Score 34 for one after the power play. It's going to be Brooks to continue from the Brian Lara Pavilion end. And he's going to have to re-bowl that one. Well, we had a chat about all things fielding. We're down with the guru of fielding. It's going to be Trevor Penny or Darren Ganga.
Thank you very much, guys. Trevor Penny, the assistant coach of this St. Kitts Nevis Patriots. What's going on with the catching? Over 40 drop catches, and we've already seen three so far.
Yeah, I know. It's as I said earlier, each team's dropping quite a few catches for no reason. It's different players in each team. And all I can say for our guys, we've dropped about 10 catches, and it's been different guy each time. So we've been trying hard in practice. Guys are practicing hard. Hopefully we can, you know, halfway through the tournament now, we can start catching them and keep winning. So we did have a laugh the other day. We keep dropping them because we keep winning. So, but we want to improve that definitely. There's no particular reason. It just seems to be one of those tournaments where there's a lot of drop catches.
Yeah, I see you've been working a lot on the catching before the start of this match. Again, this time around, you're with St. Kitts Nevis Patriots. You were with the St. Lucia Stars before. How has that experience been so far?
I'm loving it. It's my second season in the CPL, and St. Lucia was wonderful last year, and coming to St. Kitts is excellent as well. So I love these tournaments all around the world, and this CPL certainly is something very special.
And your main coach, Phil Simmons, he hails from Trinidad and Tobago. I'm sure he's been capitalizing on local knowledge about the conditions and playing against the Trinbago Knight Riders.
Oh, definitely. He's a legend here from Trinidad. So he's given the boys all the tips and stuff, and hopefully we can execute them today.
And who are the players we should look out for in this particular match? A sedate start in the power play overs. Who should we look forward to?
I think, well, Nabi's having a really good tournament. I think if he comes in later, he's going to do some damage. But all our batters to come now, they've got a bit of a license because we've got a good foundation. Hopefully we can get up to 160. Also, we've got Carlos Braithwaite. So hopefully those two can really get going in sort of the last six overs.
I hope it goes well. Always a pleasure chatting with you.
Thank you, Darren. Cheers. Thank you.
Thanks for your time there, Trev, and thanks to Darren Ganga. And a boundary has been picked up here by Brooks, so he stays at a run of ball 17. Just a quick swivel of the hips. Didn't have to try and overhit this one too much. He knew he had some space to work with.
That was good pace again from Philip. Notch below 140 k's. Rushed him slightly, hit high up on the bat near the gloves.
It's in the air for a while, but he's picked the gap beautifully. It looks like a good bit of fielding. We might just go upstairs and check it though.
Yeah, I think it's four. Possibly in contact with the ball as his feet, legs touch the rope. Darren Brava. Just, is he there? They're still in touch with it. Oh, we'll see a different angle. Might be all right. We'll just have a little check. Gregory Brathwaite will want to see another angle, possibly. Here we go. This will tell us. Holding, holding. No, he's good. Good as gold, as they say in Australia, Melanie.
Absolutely flew off the bat, but equally as good at fielding. Nice little bit of touch on that occasion.
What I like about this, in terms of you can see what Bravo's doing for young Anderson Phillip. He's now into his third over. Probably get him out the way. But, he's a bit nervy, sure. A few wides. He's dropped a couple of catches. One tough catch. But, whilst the ball's new and he's got pace, and now there is protection with the power play done. Phillip getting through his quota.
Nicely struck. There's an opportunity here for a direct, and it's been missed. Huffy's not completely happy with his call. Seven overs gone, 45 for one.
Sidearm throat, missed an opportunity.
Seven overs gone, and the Patriots at the moment, if they continue at this run rate of 6.43, we'll get to 129, which will be more below par here. And to get up above that 145, 150 is going to be even a little bit harder now, because the leading wicket taker, this hero CPL, is now coming on, Chadha Khan.
That average. Coming well below run a ball. He's been a star, and they're going to miss him, TKR, when they go on their travels. Bowling to senior player in the Pakistan side, Mohammad Hafeez.
Well, it was a great battle the other night when we had Shoaib Malik up against Shadab Khan. Last ball of the last over. Wayne Bravo going with the sidearm. Hafeez had well and truly given up.
Even in the frame. Lucky that Bravo was off with the throw, the target. Poor call by himself. Mohammad Hafeez.
Shadab Khan, last match, bowled his full quota of four overs, as he usually does, and did not get hit for one boundary. Got away with a couple, but still pretty good bowling.
Yeah, he struggled actually last match with the wet ball. Wasn't able to get as many revs on it as normal. Oh, that's gone way up in the air.
way, way up in the air. Three fielders converging. None of them get there.
Pitching wedge that just went wrong.
It's like a 64 degree up. Full swing and the ball didn't get outside the circle. Shadab's going to enjoy himself a bit more tonight. There's going to be more purchase. He can grip the ball better. He very nearly sent his countryman packing.
Andy Searle's cleaning this one up. The slog sweep. So four singles to start Shadab's spell. Batsman still looking for boundaries off the young leg spinner. Slight change in field now for Hafiz. It's Bravo just manoeuvring himself from the onside across to the offside. He's going to settle in at point. Cover sweeper in play. Hit off, hit on the wicket, backward square, and turn.
Good delivery. Lovely glove work again from Ramden as well. Keepers very rarely get a shout out in these games, but he's pouched it beautifully.
That's 50 up with a single off the last delivery of Shadab's first over. 50 for one after eight. The costumes have been absolutely outstanding. And I say that because so many of them would be, yes, it would be hot to get into them. The kids are getting involved, the adults are getting involved. I think that's Gillian. She's just merged her outfits from the last four games. Cooper, a change of ends. Comfortable single this time to Hafiz. They've opened up that space for him. Up.
I always admire Kevin Cooper and his ability to make run scoring very difficult. Another good delivery, just following the batsman, making room for himself. Shamar Brooks, Kevin Cooper, second on that list of most wickets.
There's a Dream 11 details, dream11.com/points. Select your team. Full toss. Pumped down the ground. They're going to look for two. They're coming back. This will be close. That's a direct. Yes, we'll go upstairs. This could be a brilliant piece of fielding.
The throw was really good from the deep. Shamar Brooks had to hustle back. Have a look at this again. It was Mohammed Hafiz to the danger end. Javon Searles with the throw. Looks very close. Is that bat still on the line?
It's an incredible pickup from Kevon Cooper. Ball coming in on the half volley like that. It's a brilliant pickup, brilliant take. Brings it back to the stumps. The zingers light up. It's a real tight one. I think he's gone. I think he's gone. Yeah, that pretty much confirms it.
so unfortunate for Mohammed Hafeez. We will get the confirmation. It's out. What a wonderful piece of work from first Javon Sertz, then Kevon Cooper, to retrieve the ball cleanly and dislodge the Bales. Hafeez, well, he's having a hard time with the bat in this Euro CPL. He has to go for 13. It's 52 for 2.
Two, I think he's perhaps not as quick as he once was. Searles did brilliantly, but Cooper, wow, he had so much work to do there. Could so easily have fumbled. And the opportunity slipped through his fingers, literally. But no, brilliant gather. Great work from TKR.
Cooper starts with a good one to King. Well, so often we talk about the Republic Bank classic catches. For me, you could almost put this run out in that category because the hands from Cooper at the stumps were a low-flying, bouncing half-volley thrown in hard from the outfield. Such a tough ask. Kept his cool. Didn't dislodge the Bales before the ball got there and ran out a key performer for the Patriots.
Yeah, that's why I say this guy is a quiet performer. Kevon Cooper, ball, bat, in the field. Such an asset to have in T20 cricket. He's been with the TKR for all 5 years now in CPL.
It's a tough little area to field there. It's just the edge of the square. It's a little bit sandy, and I think the spikes just sort of quite grab hold. Just watch this again. And again, Searle's done well. He's got his body orientated pretty well. But look at the hands here. That's a tough take, particularly with the pressure on, knowing that if he gathers right and he takes the Bales off, he's got the chance of running out Hafeez. Single to complete a good team over there for the Knight Riders. Nine overs gone, 54 for 2. Live easy moment, all dressed up, sitting back nice and relaxed because he's supporting the Knight Riders, and they're in a pretty good position at the moment. The two key batters out of Gale and Hafeez, and that's why the red flags are waving so high. Shadab Khan to continue. Goes for the sweet boss just off the front foot. That's brilliant, a hero maximum.
Well, it didn't really look like it was going to go all the way. That's the power of this man, Brandon King. Jamaican batsman. On plays for St. Kitts Nevis Patriots. Hitting against the spin. That's a quality shot. Gets his first hero maximum.
Shadab can't believe it. It looked as if he was going to go down for the slog sweep. I think some of the Patriots are thinking that the sweep's the best option against him. He thinks, I've done it once, I might go again. Picks up a single though on this occasion.
Brandon King, he's played a fair amount of first class cricket, 11 matches. Has a first class 100 as well. Showing his talent and class as a batsman. Boy, they'll need it Chris Gayle out early, so to Hafiz.
Brooks used the crease well. That's gone quite square. Needs a good bit of fielding. And Darren Bravo says, I can do that for you.
We saw in the last match against the Barbados Tridents, the odd cricket from this TKR team was superb. Fortunately, this game started off a little bit different. Really jump chances. The fielding in this tournament has been consistent, apart from what we've seen in the first six overs. Bravo again. Was there contact with the advertising board?
With it when he was in contact with the ball. He certainly hit it before he got the ball. He makes contact. Yeah, it looks as though they might be simultaneous. Tough because of the way the lights are glinting off that white boundary cushion. I think that one might just cinch it for us. Been quite a few lapses in play, injury to Javon Searles. Third umpire decisions. And as every run is so crucial, it's just important to get these right. There'll still be those who are calling for the ruling that if the ball doesn't go over the rope that it shouldn't be four. The laws as they are. Well, just the three. I guess the evidence was inconclusive.
Through him, well bowled, through everyone for that matter. It is a ball that not too many batsmen can pick and not too many batsmen can play.
Had a lot of pace as well on it. Dinesh Ramdin was very late in adjusting to this. Googly from Shadab Khan. Have a look at this. Before the bat comes down, it's gone. Look at Dinesh Ramdin. Didn't quite get behind this one. Good bounce as well.
Well, Ramdin didn't pick it either. His body language was that he was expecting it to be a leggy. That's how good this kid is. How deceptive his variations are. And everything pretty much in the Hero CPL has gone his way so far. Shadab Khan quite having the luck tonight. Put one down and back a point, albeit a different chance, difficult chance, and has gone for 16. Oh, that might be got for 22. That's a big hit. Brooks has stuck him over the boundary again for another hero maximum, and Shadab is getting the treatment for the first time.
Once again, just watch the wrist work. Just gets through that ball at that last second, so very, very fast. That gives him his bat speed, and that gives it a long distance on the ball as well. 75 for 2 after 10, which means we'll have a carrot break. Brendan King will be on strike. Senil Narine goes on the charge, and that is turned past. No, it's an edge. There you go. Bravo's happy. Senil Narine, as usual, just takes it in his stride. And the third wicket has gone down.
Yeah, it's the second time in this game. Ball Narine caught Bravo. The first was Chris Gayle. Now Brendan King. Use of the feet. And well, the guile of Narine gets him. Goes for nine. It's 75 for three.
At first, I thought it just spun past him. I think we all did. Goes past, rammed it, and lands in the grateful hands of DJ Bravo, who's going to give us yet another one of his El Dorado celebration specials. Turned a long, long way. Deadpool looks happy with it.
On their feet they are, the crowd, Queen's Park Oval. Their boys at the moment have three key wickets of the Patriots. Jonathan Carter now out to the middle. And he won't be thinking about stats at the moment because he's just thinking of avoiding a hat-trick ball. Senil Narine with a wicket off the last ball of his last over and a wicket off the first. Goes the reverse. There's a big shout. Senil Narine's just thinking, catch it, catch it.
Was their glove, was their bat on this one? Reverse sweep from Jonathan Carter. Despite it being a hat-trick ball, may have just rolled off the glove. And Senil Narine animated, catch it. The opportunity was there.
Don't believe it. Dinesh Ravindran appealing for the LBW. Came straight off the glove. Narine knew it. DJ Bravo knew it.
Oh! Oh! Yet again, an absolute peach. How do you play this?
Well, how do you play this delivery? And Senil Narine is only into his second over. Still two overs after this. Proved to be a big challenge for the St. Kitts Nevis batsman.
There's the reverse again. Can't get it through the field. This is the near catch. Off glove, off pad.
I don't know, can you call it a near catch if nobody tries to catch it? I don't think so. I mean, it just looked real time as though straight off the glove, straight up in the air. And the only person who didn't know it was the man in your picture.
Goes again, gets a little bit finer on this occasion, but Dwayne Bravo has adjusted the field accordingly, so there's protection.
Senil Narine, he is always a handful. This was the wicket of Brendan King. Not quite sure. He recognised that this was the current ball, just moving away from the right-hander. Getting an outside edge. Bravo made no mistake.
Yeah, good catch, because I think that also came off the tip of the glove of Ravindran. Oh. A little paddle sweep, won't get through the inner field. Good over there for the Knight Riders. A wicket and three from it, 78 for three.
It was all action. There were a lot of shots played for three runs. Could have ended up with a hat-trick. And at the moment, the home team are all over St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots like a rash.
Hear the drums, you can actually feel it sitting here in the commentary box. Lots of drums in, lots of people stamping their feet, waving the flags.
Spidey in the house.
You're a fan as a kid, Darren? I do say as a kid.
Yes, of course. Must. With great powers comes great responsibility.
Yeah, you're scaring me now. Jadhav Khan. Looking for a better over than the last. That's some pretty good running. But a little bit of tap. And for two sixes off King.
Despite this, he's a leading wicket taker in Hero CPL 2017. And so effective for the Knight Riders.
Not hard to guess what Jonathan Carter's favourite shot is, particularly to the spinners. He's brought the reverse sweep out on numerous occasions so far. As for the more traditional sweep on this occasion, there's protection backward of square.
Had his recent opportunity to play for the West Indies team. The one in the series against India, Jonathan Carter. Goes a little bit of medium pace as well. He's been amongst the runs for this St. Kitts Nevis team. We want him to carry on, get a big half century if he can. Jamal Brooks is well set.
Oh! Cricket ball on that occasion as well. That's the variety that Shadhav Khan has. As they come back for two. We've got everyone a little bit excited there for a moment.
Colin Munro getting in quickly off the fence. A couple of young whippersnappers between the sticks though. Got his head down, got motoring.
Two dot one, two. Ladder doesn't get all of it. It's just going to fall short. And once again, Shadhav Khan gets away with a loose delivery.
I just thought that the man coming in off the fence, Kevon Cooper, was going to take a few strides in and catch this, but just looks as though he lost it. Whether it went up in the lights or something was obscuring his view.
Floodlights are a little bit lower than at some grounds. What a delivery. It's past McCullum in a heartbeat and straight to the boundary.
Glorious shot to finish the over. 12 overs gone, 88 for 3. Dream 11 Fantasy Scorecard. If you've picked your list of players, more details, log on to dream11.com/points. Wonderful way of getting involved in this Hero CPL 2017. Jamal Brooks at the top of the standings. All boys at 36 from 28. Narine, mid wickets, also on that list. Top of the table clash between the Knight Riders. St. Kitts Nevis Patriots. It will be Sunil Narine into his third over.
Oh!
Again, appreciable amount of turn here for Narine. He's troubled all the batsmen he's bowled to. This was a last delivery of the last over. Played for a single. Jamal Brooks, Danny, he's done well in this innings, given his first opportunity at the top.
Absolutely, Darren. Considering he lost one of the biggest names in this fabulous format, the captain went. Caught early, bravo off Narine. And
And now more of Sunil. And play it if you can. 2 for 8, 8 dots and 2.2. And once again, he's got it on a piece of string.
Edge of the field. And another dot delivery. His spell. And then out. Christopher Henry Gale. Brandon King. Oh, they will need to score more runs. 8 runs ball, but it can get to 150 from here on in. Another reverse sweep from Jonathan Carter. This time, he will pick up another boundary.
It's been about 60% of his shots so far out the middle. Jonathan Carter really trying to knock all the spinners off their line and length with this shot. He occasionally comes with the traditional sweep, so he's got both options to hit backward or square on both sides.
Nice partnership developing between these two. 15 thus far. Very watchful against Sunil Narine, quite rightly so. One thing we've seen in this tournament, both himself and Shadab Khan have made run scoring very difficult for the opposition. In this particular match, Shadab Khan being a little bit expensive. It's over 10 runs per over, conceding runs. And a dot to finish. Not a good over from the big man, Narine. 13 overs gone, 94 for 3.
Well, the 7 overs to go in the Patriots innings, and you just wonder the batting order that they're going to look at here. You don't want to leave Carlos Braithwaite with two fewer overs.
Lots of faces in the crowd. 7 overs left in this innings for the St. Kitts Nevis Patriots. And it will be Khan into his final over. Well, still some power to come in this batting lineup. Carlos Brathwaite. This is the odd. Door gym just to the back of the Queen's Park Oval, the northern end. It's within the Nelson Mandela Park. And he's a man who is a great advocate for sports. Trinidad Tobago obviously growing in their culture for fitness and wellness. Attracts lots of families to this particular park. And he's gone. The first wicket for Shadab Khan. An ill-advised shot from Shamar Brooks. He will not be happy when he looks at this replay.
Had a brain explosion. That's all it can be put down to. Got to 37. Doing the job for his team of just 32 balls. He's the fourth man to go with the score at 95.
But you could see it coming and you're just in your mind saying, don't do it, don't do it. Oh, you've done it. Dennis Ram with the look on his face. Classic. Shadab Khan, he's getting used to that celebration because he's taken a wicket in every match of this Hero CPL.
They're jumping and waving, the Tobago Knight Riders fans. Slowly putting the stranglehold on this St. Kitts Nevis Patriots batting. Carlos Brathwaite might have other plans. We all know his potential. Awful strike off the cricket ball. Off the mark. What about his flashy red bat?
Well, I've seen a lot of bats come out to the middle and then get told, no, you can't use that. Andre Russell on the Big Bash had a black bat and all the paint was coming off on the ball, so that was banned. Ricky Ponting had a sticker on the front. They had to get rid of that. Obviously, Carlos Braithwaite has been given the go-ahead for the red bat.
Been given the green for the red. Good on you, big guy.
Cheeky single. Early just in contact with the stump. Another sleep. Big shot from Jonathan Carter. This was the dismissal. Just attempting the paddle sweep, but it all wrong.
Carlos Braithwaite was a late call-in for the Hobart Hurricanes this year in the Big Bash. Arrived, his kit hadn't arrived, but thankfully Hayley Matthews from the West Indian women's cricket team was playing out there with the Hurricanes, so he borrowed all her gear, including her bat. Must have been a little bit small in his hands, but...
Lovely shot. Does he have the distance? Through the hands. Hero maximum. Oh, Jonathan Carter, his first... in his innings.
Seen a lot of superheroes in the crowd all dressed up. This would have taken a Superman effort. 104 for four. Bronson beat the opening quick. Thought he probably had an opportunity there for a couple of seconds.
Chance going up again, yet again for the Knight Riders. Wellsford beaten. Hold on. Definitely be a buffer for Dwayne Bravo. This was the shot. To the bottom of it, but didn't quite get the elevation he wanted, but the result was good nonetheless. He knows it. Frustration. Shadab Khan well picked up two wickets in his spell. Kevin Cooper continues. He will hustle through and get to Carlos Braithwaite.
Seen some great run outs tonight, specifically Searles and Cooper to get rid of Hafiz.
That's not a good throw, that was it. Braithwaite was struggling. A throw that was even a metre closer to the stumps than that one. Dangerous man to give a life to, this guy.
And Kevin Cooper, whilst he's been economical, Shadab Khan just conceded and delivered his most expensive spell in T20 cricket. Four overs, four dots, 42 runs. Just one wicket out of Shamar Brooks. Loves to hit the ball straight down the ground, Carlos Braithwaite. He's a tall man. Gets on top of most of the deliveries. Looks to hit very straight.
He's a beast of a bloke, isn't he?
Jonathan Carter, Carlos Brathwaite, a lot about each other. Cousins, I'm told. Dream 11 Fantasy Scorecard. More details, log on to dream11.com/points. Kevin Cooper has got one over after this one. Sure that Dwayne Bravo, we haven't seen him bowl much in this competition. Recent pass, he's not been able to bowl his full quota. He's still coming off a long layoff for injury. He'll get it to the boundary. Just a single for Jonathan Carter.
Like a young George Foreman. I'm off breath, right? Absolute beast of a man. Broad shoulders. Makes the bat look like a matchstick. Gets away with using a red bat because you wouldn't tell him otherwise. Single off the last ball of the 15th. 109 for four.
So five overs to go here for the Patriots. Current run rate at 145. You probably think that's not enough, the form that the Knight Riders have been in chasing. 10 and over gets them to 159, which will be competitive.
Projected score. If they get over 10 runs for over and get close to 160. Well, the Patriots, their scoring rate in the last five overs in their last three matches has been just about 9.5. Can they achieve the same in this game? I think a lot of that had to do with Evan Lewis in their previous game against the St. Lucia Stars. Talking about stars, lots of stars in the crowd as well. Toya Woods, Universe contestant for Trinidad and Tobago.
Slightly different crowding tonight. Look at the weekend, Friday and Saturday, it was very much a grown-ups affair. Perhaps something to do with the 9 o'clock start, but I think perhaps just to do with a party atmosphere. But here on Monday night, a lot more kids in, enjoying the cricket. Oh, that's big. That's big. Huge. The Sunshine Snacks Nuts power shot of the day from Carlos Brathwaite. And that came off the bat better than that rolled off the tongue.
Well, one of the reasons why the last five overs for the Patriots have been so good throughout this tournament is because of this man. Such a clean striker of the ball. What a contest this is, Narayan Brathwaite.
Sesame Street characters in the house. Good. Narayan to Brathwaite. Get a single. Make it two. Good running. Jonathan Carter. Very quick between the wickets. Talking about sixes. You all could remember Carlos Brathwaite and his series of sixes in the final over of the ICC T20 World Cup. 2016, able to get the West Indies over the line against England. And another boundary to him. He is doing the business for his team here.
He's got such long levers, a very tall man, good reach, which usually means good bat speed. And if the ball's coming off his bat at decent pace, it usually means it gets to the boundary even quicker. Colin Munro, for a split second, would have thought I might have a chance.
See something on the right.
very, very keen not to get the ball onto the driver Brathwaite's back. So he's dragging his length back. I suppose is where that sweep shot comes in. Credit to the batsman that he's able to adjust and change his hitting area.
Hey Mark, he's one of the few players, Carlos Brathwaite, to take the attack to Sunil Narine. That's a big difference in mindset. He's doing it to good effect. Minor delivery for Sunil Narine. A wonderful spell comes to an end. Just conceding 12 runs and two very important wickets. 16 overs gone, 122 for 4.
Three of the four wickets taken this evening, again by the spin of Narine and Shadad Khan. That's forming into a wonderful bowling partnership for the Knight Riders.
Well, the excitement continues here at the Queen's Park Oval. Plenty of people beyond the boundary line. Let's go on to Danny Morrison.
Thanks, guys. Well, it's all about, well, colour, pageantry. It is the Queen's Park Oval after all, isn't it? I mean, this place has it all. Uh-oh, look out. This could be out. And oh, yes! Back upstairs to Youth Bay!
Talk about the popcorn machine. Popped in and up. Luckily, Phillips, he holds on this time. Simple catch, yet again, proven to be challenging. Carlos Brathwaite, well, he's gone for a quick fire 19. It's 122 for 5.
Huge wicket. This is the man that could really motor a total up well beyond that 160 mark. That's why the Knight Riders are so happy, and the fans as well. Putting reasonably cheaply 19 from 12. And the Knight Riders will be hoping that just stems the run flow a little bit, wrestles the game back in their favour.
Well, they're jumping. Jumping for joy, Knight Riders. Up another wicket, wicket number 5. Big one of Carlos Brathwaite. It has allowed Mohammed Nabi come to the crease.
Yeah, made a magnificent 24 from just 9 deliveries in the Patriots' dismantling of the St. Lucia Stars last time out. You're going to need something of the same ilk in this game, because at the minute they're falling short. And that wicket of Brathwaite was huge in terms of the way that this game is going, the way these last 4 overs are heading. Oh, you didn't want to drop that, you really didn't. He tried his best. Kevon Cooper picks up another wicket though. And that man is mighty relieved.
They're very smart from Kevin Cooper, just pulling it wide, making it become difficult and challenging for Carlos Brathwaite to reach for it and go squarer through the offside. We're going to rejoin Danny Morrison sideline.
Yeah, it's happening. Drums are going off. Hey, I've got Cullen, the Knight Rider. Mate, love your outfit. Who's your favourite TKR player?
TKR, Dwayne Brown for his athleticism.
You reckon they're going to win tonight?
Huh? Sorry?
They're going to win tonight?
Of course, we're all going to win.
Stupid question. And hey, out of the Deadpool, via Bollywood and Trini, here he is, George from the Deadpool. Brother, love your outfit. Where did you get your outfit?
I came from America to support Sunil Narine.
Outstanding. Who's your favourite star player?
Sunil Narine.
Oh, Sunil Narine. And I've got the dynamic duo.
I've got Rebecca Superwoman and the partner extraordinaire, Brandon Newton. Now tell me, Superwoman, Rebecca, you made these outfits.
Yeah, we did, we did.
Sensational. And you made yours too?
No, I didn't.
Oh, naughty. And who do you want to win?
Dicker.
Star player?
No, I.
Your favorite player, Brandon?
My favorite player is Dwayne Bravo. Most definitely.
Well, there you go. Stars galore. We're loving it here. Hero CPL for 2017.
Thank you, Danny. For a moment, I thought they would say Danny Morrison. Lots of exciting actors out there. Mark. More importantly, Mohamed Nabi. He's yet to be dismissed. Talk about characters. Republic Bank dugout. Blue Devils in action. Wonderful over comes to an end. Kevin Cooper, early motors on. 17 overs gone, 130 for 5.
It's been really consistent wickets falling here for the Patriots. Two big early wickets, Gale and Hafiz, really put them on the back foot. And Brooks and Carter got together at the fall of King. What a good partnership. And of course, again, the Knight Riders fought back. 130 for 5.
Yeah, some starts in that batting scorecard. Jamal Brooks at the top of the innings. Jonathan Carter, well set at 30. Good strike rate. Just under 150. Patriots, they have a good opportunity to get beyond 160. See if they can get over 10 runs for over from here on in. Hunsford beaten. It's usually very good back end of the innings. It is third over.
That's nicely played. Really nicely played from Nabi. Beaton goes for the Yorker again. He usually gets it in there. And Nabi is nimble enough to turn it round the corner and open up his boundary account. Very, very handy cricketer, this man. Representing Afghanistan with pride.
Yeah, I like how he gets that front foot out of the way very early. Gets square onto the ball. This gives him the angle. Man at fine leg. Changes your batting stance and your batting guard can make a big difference in terms of finding the gap. There's four fielders within the 30-yard circle, three on the offside, one at short fine leg. Beaten. A classy shot. This man, well, he's done the business for the Patriots numerous times. This is a proper cricketing shot.
Clean, clean contact. Slower ball from Beaton. Certainly didn't deceive Mohamed Nabi. Crunched it over extra cover. No! This is looking like a decent total. And maintain this momentum with their bowling attack, it may be a challenge in the second half.
Early pressure on Beaton, two boundaries off the first two deliveries. Can he hold his composure? Dwayne Bravo, we've not seen him in this bowling lineup today. Always very animated, funky. To have a chat, gets into the mind of his opposition number. It's a good chemistry with Karen Pollard, and so too Chris Gayle.
already 9 runs from this over. Good effort between these two. 17 from 8 in terms of the partnership.
It's great to see in those clips DJ Bravo not taking things too seriously, but when he steps over the line, when the contest is on, it's all business. Good from Beaton.
Mohammed Nabi in a T20 match in March 2017, got 89 of 30 deliveries against Ireland. 6 fours and 9 sixes. Real potential in terms of talent with the bat. He will have the opportunity to bowl as well later on. Wonderful international player out of Afghanistan. Was asking for a wide, umpire Nigel Dugid doesn't concede to that request.
Yeah, I'm not sure, but I don't think Jonathan Carter's too impressed with this. He might have had a case. That's the home team getting a bit of an advantage there.
A little pattern sweep from Jonathan Carter. Very innovative in his innings so far. 9 runs from it. End of over number 18, it's 140 for 5.
Monday night, but that doesn't stop the fans from coming out. You can just see that Manhattan just ever so slightly creeping up from over 12 onwards. Manhattan at the moment showing just a slow, steady increase. Over 10 was a big one, 21 from it, the biggest of the evening. And then nearly every second over into double figures.
First visit to the bowling crease of the innings in the 19th over. Slower ball. No surprise, you've been tuning in to the TKR home games. Precious dot ball to start off with.
Yeah, go-to delivery for the captain of TKR. Now 11 deliveries left. Tens gets them close to 160. Dearly love to get that. To ask 8 and over from the get-go for TKR.
Another slowie. Oh, get back. Oh, he's gone. He's gone. The skipper into the action straight away, and we've got an El Dorado celebration. Champion style.
Champion. He is. There's never a single ear. He might have wanted it, Jonathan Carter. No way, Jose, says Mohammed Nabi. Out for 31, of just 26, 140 for 6.
Well, if you have the mindset of playing a fast delivery from Dwayne Bravo from the get-go, starting off on the wrong footing. Majority of his deliveries are slower deliveries. Must set yourself for playing them. Jonathan Carter deceived. Run out.
Another slow ball. Thomas opens his account. 156. Highest score. The team batting first at Queen's Park Oval. This year's hero, CPL. See the demise of Jonathan Carter. Uh-oh. Get Carter. And he was got.
Yeah, smart from Mohammed Nabi, not sacrificing his wicket. The run was never on. Jonathan Carter puzzled by the slowness of the delivery. And caught in no man's land.
Slowy again. Brilliant this from the skipper. Kept his powder dry right the way up until the 19th over of the innings. His 350th game. Only one man has more. Kieran Pollard. Economy of 8 and over, considering that he's bowled most of those at the death. Sometimes 4 off the reel at the back end of an innings. Some T20 career. Slowy again. This time it's picked. Oh, it's picked up and deposited way, way back for a huge hero maximum.
Picked the bones out of this one. Gone miles. 150th maximum so far, the hero CPL. And I just noticed that DJ Bravo slightly missed his run up there. Lost a little bit of rhythm. So he drags this one slightly down and Mohammed Nabi says, I'll have every piece of this.
Oh, quicker ball, short, out, no mistake from Searles. And he's dancing again. Nabi's got to go this time. Nice little cameo of 17 from 8 for him. But Bravo picks up another. Nabi gone for 17 from 8. 147 for 7 with one to go.
Pump for 6. And just shows you the gears that DJ Bravo can go through to change it up and get people out. One of the masters of it in this short format.
Pakistan's Hassan Ali, the new batsman, 23 years of age, a seriously good right-arm quick bowler. Much to shout about with the bat at the moment. He's not required. Non-striker's end. Runs for Beaton to finish off things from the media end. Big finish required here from St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. And they post something in excess of 156. Highest total to be made batting first here this year.
Come on, you Patriots. 3 on the bounce. We're confident as prior to the toss of the coin. And we're looking fondly at this contest. Because of the stage, the theatre that is, the Queen's Park Oval.
Yeah, the umpires just checking from the previous dismissal of Nabi. If the batsmen have crossed, just trying to get it right as to who will be on strike. It will be Devon Thomas.
Thank you. goes for the Yorker. Brilliant from Beaton. Ron Thomas there with the Douglas Jardine style neckerchief. That's a bit natty, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, it is rather close, as they say in the United Kingdom. Seen some other devices there too. Years ago, last century, dipped them in the old ice and soaked them, and they would slowly release. You give them a squeeze and they'd be nice and cold. But I do like the cravat.
I say, old boy. 5 balls to go. Again, goes full. Oppressive in terms of atmosphere, impressive in terms of beating.
Well, this will test him for the game. End of the match of the Hero CPL. Yeah, it's Pakistan Independence Day. Since he's, look at, he's painted up the arm. Notice that when I said congratulations on the ICC Champions Trophy. I said, well done, son. Great effort, wonderful achievement. And now he's got the arm covered in the flag, the national flag. Independence Day. Hassan Ali pumped for match 13. Is he pumped with bat in hand here? Only 4 deliveries left. He'd dearly love to get close to 160, let alone 150.
Slammed. Oh, it's gone miles. Happy Independence Day indeed, Zikabad.
Celebration. The power of Hassan Ali. He's not only good with the ball, look at this powerful strike. Down the ground, off the middle of the bat, and picks his spot.
Yeah, missed his length with that subtle change-up. It's in the slot. So it is that length where batters, even tail-enders, love to get underneath and dispatch it. Hassan Ali, only striking at 600.
Yeah, decides to go back to the Yorker. Served him so well. Thomas looking to get Van Ali back on strike. 155 for 7. Said before, 156. Highest total on the team batting first here. TKR did manage to chase that down against the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Three top draw spinners though in this Patriots team. Hassan, Mohammed Nabi, Mohammed Hafiz, Tabriz Shamsi. To mention Samuel Badri.
Yep. I was now going to remind you of him at the top of the innings with the new ball. Will prove to be dangerous on this surface. Just get a couple to spin as well. Always a difficult proposition with that new ball. Skiddy type bowler, low trajectory. Phil Simmons already thinking about bowling.
Stats gurus, after 15, the Patriots were 109 for 4 after 15 overs. Wonderful comeback in the death overs by the visitors.
Goes for that Yorker again. Must come back for 2. Kevon Cooper goes to the keeper's end. And they get back and they've done it. They've posted the highest total here at Queen's Park Oval. TKR will need 159. Win a hat-trick of home games here in the Hero CPL. It's not going to be straightforward. Not big smiles on the faces of DJ Bravo. They know they've got a contest on their hands here.
The Patriots, the only unbeaten team in this year's Hero CPL. High on confidence, playing together as a team. They've had some individual standout performances. Chris Gayle with the bat. Evan Lewis, who's not in today. But they've rallied together as a batting unit to post a good total.
on what is a track that would assist the spinners. This is what transpired with the bat. Shamar Brooks top scoring with 37 from 32. Very good support from Carter, Brathwaite and Nabi in the end.
Yeah, a bit of a mixed bag. I mean, Anderson Phillip, he was on debut, a bit nervy, so he'll get that one out the way. Beaton, he disappeared for a bit for him. He's normally a lot more economical than that. But you look at 2 for 26, no surprises. The usual suspects, Cooper, Shadab and Bravo getting a wicket apiece.
So all that means that the Trinbago Knight Riders require 159 runs to win. Just a smidge under 8 runs per over. We're going to take a short break and come back and see the run chase.
Every pitch, every pond, every deal, every wicket, every stone. And the heart and soul and passion, and the culture, Caribbean blood.
It's how
when
we play.
Come out all nation, be the team in a unification. When the stadium run beach at the grandstand, and the meaning of beautification.
It's how we play.
Last home game for the Knight Riders, and they sent the Patriots in and got the two early wickets of Gale and Hafiz, which certainly helped things. But Brooks and Carter put on a good partnership in the middle order. Some late end firepower from Braithwaite and Nabby got them up to 158, the highest score at Queen's Park Oval this Hero CPL. So the Digicel highlights bundle started well with almost an absolute blinder. That was Philip coming into the game, but then the very next delivery, Narine got his man.
Yeah, pressure had been building on Chris Gale, and Narine bowled him an absolute beauty. Drop catches have been the story of the CPL so far. There's another couple. Dab Khan almost clinging on to a ripper at backward point. Then there was this piece of brilliance. Searles into Kevon Cooper. Brilliant hands, wonderful pickup. And that saw the end of Hafiz. Magnificent striking from Brooks and King. And that was the end of King, caught by Dwayne Bravo behind. His second catch at slip. Patriots kept plugging away though. Shadab went for his worst figures of the CPL, but still managed to pick up a wicket. And then the big man with the big red bat came out and was just starting to get motoring when he was dismissed, caught by Philip off the bowling of Kevon Cooper. Ahmed Nabi proving so handy down at the back end of the innings for the Patriots. He was able to peel off one or two boundaries before DJ Bravo brought himself on for the 19th. His only over of the match. Picked up a run out, knocked over Nabi, and gave us all a boogie or two. Hassan Ali wasn't out there for long, but long enough to send one miles over the long off boundary. And in the end, they posted 158 for 7, 2 for 26 for Narine. So consistent, you would expect very little else. One for Cooper, staying hot on the heels of Shadab Khan at the top of the wicket takers. Shadab with 1 for 42, and Dwayne Bravo, the skipper, just the one over, 1 for 7.
Wonderful to see all the supporters of the game walking around the ground in this mid-innings break. There's the Carrick girls. And right at the back, you've got the Guardian volunteers as well, and they're getting a huge cheer from everyone here because they know how important they are to the whole vibe of this game. They're the volunteers there, the Guardian group volunteers, all dressed in orange. They're the reason why everyone enjoys this game so much, because they put in a power of effort so that all the fans can sit back, relax, and enjoy the cricket. Some do it in a very chilled way, others are a little bit more animated. You never know. You might see some of these youngsters out playing in the CPL or the West Indies men's or women's team in the near future. It just does not stop here. That's one of the most exciting things of it. The drums are beating right throughout. Bouncer, the Hero CPL mascot, just keeps bouncing all night long. There might be a little bit of nerves in the crowd though, because it's the highest score put on here by the any opposition, so it's going to be a good run chase. The Hero Motorcorp leaderboard has the home team, the Knight Riders, sitting pretty at the moment on top. 8 points to their name, played 5, 1, 4, just lost the one against Jamaica. And they're up against the team in position number 2, the Patriots, who have 6 points, because they have not lost a game as yet, followed by the Tridents, Talawars, Warriors and St. Lucia Stars. Things about to get underway. Chris Gayle leads his team out. Another senior player to left of screen. That was Mohammed Hafiz. Samuel Badri there just sliding on by. He'll be very important in attempting to defend this total. And then two powerhouses. Who, we would never have said that 3 years ago about Sunil Narine, but he's been in pretty good form of late. And for them to chase this down, they'll be hoping that the openers of Brendan McCullum, left of screen, and Sunil Narine can get them off to a flyer. Yeah.
TKR looking at eight, pretty much fractionally under that per over. Soon on the right, he's left-handed. So lease of life in 2017, where he started to come up the order and open the batting as a pinch hitter with the free license, it would seem, to get after the bowling inside the first six overs of the power play. Brendan McCullum, well, we know his pedigree, wonderful strike rate in T20 cricket all around the globe, pretty much 146 here, Hero CPL, and he's up against the professor, nicknamed Muhammad Hafeez. These are great numbers too. Economy rate there of bang on six. So spin to start the second innings. Nestle countdown here at the Queen's Park Oval for the run chase. Now let's get ready. Starting from the same end is that TKR started their bowling. Brian Lara Pavilion end for Hafeez. Oh, DG, how do you see this one? Early doors.
Buckle up, because it's going to be fireworks. These two guys, ultra aggressive.
Hey. McCullum, he looked to get off the mark. He's had some very short stays, and a golden duck, of course, earlier in the week. He's shown glimpses of his class, but never really kicked on, whereas Sunil Narine got 79, was man of the match, and so he is in good touch.
We're due to see a lot of overs of spin bowled here. Dew doesn't seem to have made such a nuisance of itself as it has done in the past games we've seen here at the Queen's Park Oval. And the Patriots have got plenty of options when it comes to tweak. This is going to be a great game. All the ingredients for a tight finish.
Oh, be careful, Sunil. Now, this is what Hafeez enjoys. He loves taking on the left-hand opening batters.
Indeed. He'll get that ball to spear into Sunil Narine. See off the inside edge already. No turn. That angle is a difficult angle to get under.
That's a nice little flick. Open spaces, but control. Nothing outrageous. Didn't want to go too massive. So Narine underway as well.
He can afford to bowl that line. There's protection for Sunil Narine. Long on. Deep mid-wicket. Chris Gayle will be strategizing well within the six overs in the par play.
Long on, deep mid-wicket, only two out.
Gotcha!
Oh, careful, Brendan McCullum. He had a heart in his mouth for a split second. He got caught by Jesse Ryder in a similar position not long ago.
Yeah, this ball pitching wicket to wicket. Such a risky shot. If he misses, well, they could be in with a good LBW shot. Oh, but Hafeez doesn't mind taking that chance early in the innings.
Yep.
Oh, good memory there. In match six, that was, caught Jesse Ryder at short mid wicket off the bowling of Shane Shillingford. Narine, nobody wanted to catch him at all last night. And again, it's evaded the gloves. Devon Thomas, keeper, unable to gather. They have taken a deflection off the pad. It has done. One down, five for none.
Thank you. best in the business in this form of the game. Now, I thought about Samuel Badry, and they're going to say, no, we're going to go for pace. We'll go with Carlos Brathwaite, and so we'll have spin and pace. And we'll get to Samuel Badry soon enough, I'm sure.
Yeah, I like this from Chris Gayle. One of the best things you can do as a captain is make your team and your approach unpredictable. A lot of people expect that Samuel Badry will open the bowling. He's not today.
Squirt one here. Brathwaite wants to have a little warm-up. Shot at the poles. This will be interesting. I'm looking forward to this. Carlos Brathwaite up against Sunil Narine. Narine with this wonderful innings of 79. So good at straight. Just a little flick, isn't it? Uppercuts, scores in some neat parts of the ground. Swivels and on the charge and says, look, don't bowl those, Chief. I'll go miles.
His head's so still. Sometimes the backswing's unorthodox, unusual. Eyes are level, head still. Wonderful coordination between the two things in his head and the thing in his hands.
Run there. We've got a wide slip in. The captain's there, Gayle, and it's sort of like a gully position. It's like a very deep gully, sort of short third man. Because Badria comes walking in with the bowler.
They're changing the field. Runnet cover coming to short mid wicket, just balancing the field a little bit more. Chris Gayle.
It's enough of this. Couple of bounces and she's into the rope already. Boundary time for Sunil Narine.
Well, we've seen a lot of this from his bat when he batted against the Barbados Tridents. Doesn't really commit that front foot. Gives himself a lot of time to play the ball. Picked his spot and executed well.
Bowl this one. Thank you, Nigel. Do good. Bowlers just get a little rattled. Understandably, particularly against someone who's so unorthodox. And then starts to move around the crease, then doesn't, keeps really still. On other occasions, he'll give himself a little bit of room. Want to go over extra cover. Brathwaite under pressure. Oh, up in the air. Who wants it? Mohammad Nabi. And takes it. Trevor Penny will be pleased about that.
It's a Republic Bank classic catch from Mohammad Nabi. Makes no mistake. It went high into the air. Had the composure. Judged it really well. Very early. Settled. And completed the catch cleanly. Sunil Narine goes for 5. 11 for 1.
Well, perhaps they were expecting Badry. Chris Gayle pulled a rabbit out of the hat. Big rabbit, Carlos Brathwaite. And he's done the job sending back Sunil Narine. And Nabi has done what many could not do on Saturday night, and that's hold on to a catch.
Pretty good time of it here. Hero CPL Season 5, non-striking end. Cullen crossed with Sunil Narine. Brathwaite. It's hunting up. Yeah. Good start for the Patriots.
Well, Chris Gayle, he will be mindful that Sunil Narine took
the attack to Samuel Badri. During the IPL this year, when he scored a half century of 15 deliveries, equaling the record for the fastest 50 in IPL. And he was really vicious against Samuel Badri. So just protecting Badri on this occasion, getting rid of Sunil Narine.
Squirt from Munro. He gets off the mark, keeps a strike. Two bold, 13 for one.
That's a good call, Darren Ganga. I was there that night. Eden Gardens. 65,000 people on a boiling hot night. Sunil Narine just took Samuel Badri apart. KKR actually had four bowlers capable of 90 mile an hour plus in that side, and they didn't bowl him at him. He just kept belting Badri. So good call, very good call.
One down early, and it's the very dangerous Sunil Narine. Didn't trouble the scorers too much. Now it's Colin Munro and his countryman Brennan McCullum, the TKR. Be very watchful here, Mr. Munro.
Yeah, a lot will depend on these two. They've been batting really well for the Knight Riders. Lord, in this Knight Riders team hasn't really been performing that well. High in the air, doesn't have the distance. This man is powerful, and he gets his first hero maximum very early in the innings.
Out this guy gave a masterclass to our very own Danny Morrison before the start of play. Talking about the way that he's developed his game. He mentioned playing against spin against the new ball, but it certainly looks as though he's got the idea of that as well. Prolific run scoring from Munro. Fast or slow, it's got to go.
Sure does. A race with the hero maximums. Pollard at the top of the tree and Munro not far behind. Cullum, no surprise there, and Big D Sammy and a certain Sunil Narine not far off the pace as well. Duckman's out of control. Scary. Happiest fan alive candidate for certain. It's all happening. One of the greatest places on earth to watch T20. I changed that ball, yeah, and that six was hit from Munro. Bounced on the concrete in front of the side screen at the pavilion end. Maybe that's caused a little concern for it. Might have put it out of shape fractionally. Some great outfits here. That's it, up you get. Swing the sword and the shield, and look out. Monday night madness here in the capital. Nothing short of it. Oh, I might have gone to the drum and got damp. Give us another new one. Munro.
This is a good angle. Just coming back into Munro. Giving himself room to hit through the offside. Favors the onside. He said at the start of play.
Sweet. Really sweet.
Glorious as well. Looks really good when he's on the attack. Colin Munro. Very classy. Gets to the pitch. Carries his arms through this one.
The error. The thing that will upset Mohammed Hafeez is the width that he gave Colin Munro there. He still had plenty of work to do. Four men in the ring on the offside, and he beat them all.
Now
Eldorado happiest fan. Amy Matthews, yeah, caught up with him a couple of years ago on the avenue. Oh, he's a character. He is one heck of a character. The juggling act was a sight to behold. Extraordinary. Absolutely extraordinary. Had a stubby on his head, dancing, flicking his legs through his front hands in a press-up position without spilling a drop. Brilliant.
That sounds like you at breakfast, Dan. Three gone, 25 for one.
Dream 11 Fantasy Scorecard to date with this match, match 13. Bravo is at the top so far with his performance. Then Brooks, Narayan, of course, is bowling. Jonathan Carter, Kevin Cooper bringing up the rear. Ah, yes, the Duck Man. Well, I'll tell you what, the Eldorado happiest fan alive. Two fans from each region, chance to win here. At the Hero CPL, the finals, you can jump on the Caribbean Airlines, full VIP treatment to come here. I tell you what, Duckman is in with a chance. He's a candidate for sure, because we're going to be announcing a winner tonight, because of course it's the last match here in the Port of Spain for the round robin of this part of the tournament. So often, the ball has been going to short fine leg this whole week with that sort of stroke.
And luckily, it finds the fielder. Could have easily been four runs for Colin Munro. That's Brad Tweed. He's just balanced his field a bit. Not opting to give Munro much width. Keeps it very straight. There's a change in the field. Long one back. Third man comes into the 30-yard circle.
Road downtown. Can't get it past Mohammad Nabi. Afghanistan superstar in the way. Already taken a catch tonight.
Yeah, just brilliance of this man. A true professional. Contributes with bat, ball, in the field. Wonderful asset to have in T20 cricket. Member of the Sunrisers Hyderabad team. The recent IPL as well.
It's a good over so far from Brathwaite. Just a couple of singles, four deliveries.
Just living every single ball in the crowd here. Party going on, yes, but they care about their team winning. Know that a win here will guarantee them a place in the finals, in the playoffs. Hat-trick of victories if they pull one off tonight.
Beautifully disguised. So we've got one left in the over, only two off it so far. McCullum, with all his experience, won't get angst here. A wonderful little leg cutter. Asking rate is only just over eight, so early days in this run chase. Oh, one hand off the play, and it runs away to ruin the over somewhat. Six off at 30, one for one.